Hi, I'm Lisa McMann, author of The Wake Trilogy and Crier's Cross. Crier's Cross is my new book. It comes out February 8th, and it is about a town where teens in a really small high school disappear. And it's kind of a creepy story. There's a lot of suspense, and of course there's a love story too. You can see the book right here, actually. See? This is Crier's Cross. Check it out. February 8th. My other books, Wake, Fade, and Gone. It's a trilogy about a girl who gets sucked into other people's dreams. So it's kind of creepy, paranormal, like that. And those books are all out. And I think you might be able to see them right here on that shelf. This is my shrine. This is what my family calls my shrine. It's where my books go in our library. I started writing when I was in fourth grade. That's when I first remember really doing a lot of writing in school, and my teacher told me that I did a really good job. And so I got to go to this event at a local college for young writers. It was called the Young Authors Conference. And I remember going there and thinking this is the coolest thing in the world, mostly because I wanted to get out of school because I hated school. But also because I liked to write. So, these are my kitties down here. Can you see them? They're just running around. What inspires me to write? That's a really good question. I get inspired by dreams. I get inspired by nature and by funny things people say when you don't expect, when they don't expect to be heard. I get inspired by a lot of things, mostly dreams though. I get a lot of my ideas from dreams. When I was in high school, I was pretty much a total geek and kind of dopey and I wasn't popular at all. I did a lot of writing in high school, and I did have one teacher who really helped me out a lot. He really believed in me as a writer, and that made a big difference in my life as a teenager. But as far as my social life went, not so great. Writing first person versus third person. It's a constant debate over how to do it and when you should do it and when you shouldn't do it. And, you know, I feel like it just should come to you. You should feel it. You should feel the story before you actually start writing. That's the way it happened for me with Wake. I ended up just starting it in third person, and it just went that way, and that's how the book came to me. One of my books coming up next year in 2012 is in first person, and that was right for that book. So you just gotta really trust your gut on some of that stuff. As far as tips, I think one of the best things you can do as a writer is to go find the book that you totally love, the one that you go back to over and over again. Read it again, but this time read it like a writer. And take notes. What makes you want to keep reading even though you already know how the story ends? Think about it. Think about the scenes. Is it the action? Is it the characters? Go through that book as if you're a writer and then try and copy some of that stuff. Copy those techniques in your own writing. You can find out more about my books and about me and about movie potential news, stuff like that, on my website, which is lisamcmann.com. Thanks for listening, thanks for watching, and have a great day!